So you can see I'm on a video roll now. They got my internet at home. Hey, I'm good to go, man. You give me an internet, man, and I'm happier than a lark. Now I just got to put my practices that I learned, because I spent the summer outside. I spent the winter outside, man. I didn't stay inside during the winter. I made a little rocket stove outside, because it's colder inside the house than it is outside during the winter. This house gets cold, and during the summer, it for some reason this house just stays nice and cool in the summer, man. Naturally, for some odd reason, man. Must be the way it was built. Must be the way that the walls were built and everything, the paint that they use, and the spackle on the walls, and all that good stuff, and the blessing that's on this house. So. Now I got a little excited in the last video because for some reason, but now I'm kind of, I got everything out. I ejaculated all the stuff out my mouth that I wanted to say. So. See, now these mouths right here are just another form of masturbation. Ejaculating all those words out. See, I was having mouth sex, word sex, man. You know, I hadn't had any word sex for a long time. I've been holding back, man. I haven't been able to make a video like this in a long time. About when the power got cut off last winter. It's been over a year. Power got cut off. In fact, the power got cut off on November 25th. I remember. It was Thanksgiving Day. Well, the following Monday. The day before the holiday, I got the pink slip in the mail, or on the door. Said, we're cutting. So, December, January, February, so 13 months, 14 months, but, so I'm due for some ejaculations with the mouth, but I gotta learn how to regulate that, though, you know, because it tenses up my lower back, causes my lower back to burn. What I need is some weed, man, because it helps me a lot to be able to calm down. And I know why it does, too. I'm talking about the technical reasons in the brain and the nerves and blood vessels. They get constricted, tight, and they don't allow the oxygen to flow. Called tension myotis syndrome, TMS. Read a book on that, so... But I put the two together with the oxygen and the weed. Basically, it's called oxygen deprivation. When the tips of the blood vessels or the nerves are constricted, oxygen does not get to the tissue, which would be cartilage or muscle or any other type of tissue. When oxygen is deprived from entering to the tissue, then you get what's called pain. But it's not a harmful pain. It's not a damaging pain. It's just a side effect of pain. Because the tissue is still good. It's not damaged. It's all through repressed emotions, psychological. So my repressed emotions are what's causing me to get all hyper and ejaculate at the mouth right now. And I'm dealing with those things. And one of the things that helps me is marijuana. Big time, because it opens up the blood vessels. It opens up the blood flow, increase of oxygen. See? When you understand what these chemicals do, and this is natural plant salts from the chemicals of the earth, Mother Nature's natural salts, man. Those little crystals, little white little crystals on those plants, they're like little stems with little crystal balls on them. You look at them on a microscope, get a High Times magazine or something, YouTube it. You can see what the cannabis looks like. It looks like little mushrooms, a mushroom stem, but instead of a half ball, it's a full ball. It's a sphere sitting on a stem. And that's what you call the salt crystal. It contains the minerals, the salts that open up the blood vessels. A That's why I say the salts of salvation. This is all tied into the zodiac. Now, I have yet to experiment with the salts. I have some salts, and I did some experiments. One thing I noticed, too, I started taking good sea salt, and I noticed that my skin, my elbows weren't drying out, my kneecaps weren't drying out, so that automatically told me, okay, there's something to this. This ain't just some talk that's going on. Our bodies live off minerals, and minerals is just another name for salts. When you read about the 12 different salts that there are, you spend 9 months in the womb, but you're deficient of 3 salts for those extra 3 months that you don't spend in there that you would have got from mama. And it's done like that on purpose to send you on a search to find the missing salts. But most of us are depleted of all the salts, man. Everything in the world we eat is all sugar-coated. Everything. Sugar, 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 sugar. Ain't nothing natural about all the food that we eat, man. It's all depleted. Bleached. No nutrients in it at all. Think about that. And then it's pumped up with all kinds of artificial stuff. That book gave me a real eye-opener about what our food is. Now, the only reason why I was able to read all these books is because I cut the power. Otherwise, I'd be here on these YouTube videos doing guitar and all that. I cut the power, and then my instincts told me to cut the power. I cut the power to my house on purpose. Because my instincts told me that I needed to do something. I needed that power off. And now I know why. It's because I read all these books. I didn't just read them. I studied them, and I wrote books on top of them. And I decoded it, put them all in different languages. Now, I'm not talking about the different languages of the world. I'm talking about an easier to understand language for the common layman. Not for the doctor who understands Czechoslovakia. You know, 15-letter words and stuff like that. I'm talking about 3-letter words, 4-letter words, 5-letter words, 1-syllable words, 2-syllable words. I'm not talking about 8-syllable words that are 20 letters long that were made for doctors to understand. I took all those words and I condensed them down into simplification, 1-syllable, 2-syllable words with freaking 3 letters, 5 letters, you know, 7 letters. Because my heart is for the people who don't have understanding, man. But my heart is also for the people that do got understanding, but their understanding is out of balance. They're too technical. That's what you call the Western side. It's all science, man, on the Western side. Technology. Start studying the Eastern side of the world, you start realizing, oh, shoot, the gut feeling. The gut feeling doesn't need no technology. But it's good to have the technology and the scientific proofs. So with the microscope, you can put everything under the microscope to back up what you're feeling, what your gut feelings are. And you're like, oh. That's why you find the balance between the two, East and West. Boom. See what I'm saying? Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, I had to cut the power off. I instinctually knew I had to do it. And I didn't go try to put the electric utility company on my UCC1 as the debtor either. I could have done that and had my power restored, but I knew I had to cut it. Because there was something calling me. There was a calling for me. Just like why I'm turning the power on right now, all by faith, trying to manifest that bank account. Because it's just welling up in me like fire shut up in my bones. It's coming. I can feel it. So I'm going all out, man. I can feel the energy rising in me, man. I can taste that account so close. I was just walking through the stores. You know what it's like to have the feeling? Even though I was writing trust checks, you know what the feeling's like to walk through the store to know that you can just pull anything off the shelf that you need? To experience what that feeling is like? I'm telling you, it was pretty much like the same feeling when I quit my job 6 years ago and I had $130,000 in the bank to trade on the Forex market. And it was like, oh my God, just walking through the town, driving my car to the freaking town, like I don't have to work no more. What a freaking feeling, man. I don't have to work no more. I'm freaking free just to experience the feeling, man. Oh my God. And now just walking through the store realizing, and I would just go through the store. I say, damn, I'm hungry for that. I wouldn't even look at the price. At first I was looking at the price. So I was like, oh God, that's a little bit too much. And then I realized, shit, don't matter what the price is. The price is insignificant. These little trinket dollar bills just turned into, and the checks just turned into like tickets to me. Like coupons. Here, like you rip out of the newspaper. It was just like, here's a coupon. That was the mentality, man. Shit. That's all this is. Everything here is for me, for you, for us all, you know. Just go to the shelf, grab them. I need some socks. I grab some socks off, man. Shit. What a feeling, man. So it was good to experience that, because now I got a taste, I got a memory. Like, you know, if you ever watch Abraham Hicks, she'll tell you, imagine what it's like. And I'm going to tell you right now, it's kind of hard to imagine it unless you actually go through it and experience it. Now you really have experience you can imagine, because now you got a taste for it. Now you want more of it. Now you can recall that feeling because you actually did it. You actually lived it. You actually went to the shelf. You pulled stuff off the shelf. You went to the cash register and you gave them a check. And say, this check is in trust with your mind. You didn't tell the cashier that. You knew exactly. Everything is already prepaid. Just to be able to do it and go through the line and walk out the store with product. That is a feeling that you can build on. Say, I'm going to manifest that now. Oh, yeah. Baby, it's coming. Yeah. So you can feel it. You know, I got a little overexcited. I was a little tense in the back, but I kind of forgot about my world out here. I got to come back to myself. And when I do start coming back to myself, I realize, okay, you know, I get more mellow. But like I said, the cannabis helps a lot. I got to play the hell out of my acoustic guitar out in the backyard, man. This winter, I was playing it so hard, I broke 5 of the 6 strings and still kept playing. And then finally just kept the song going on one string, man. I played for about 2 hours. Broke one string, broke another, broke another, broke another. That was the first time I ever did it that many strings in one setting, man. And it still only got one string on it. Oh, well, it was only 4 strings. It still got 2 on it. See? You know. One of the big eye-openers was that big blue book by Manly P. Hall called The Secret of All Ages. And I had that power cut off, man, so I was able to sit out in the backyard and just read book after another, one book after another. I think it took me about a month to read that book. But I did. I read every word and every caption under the pictures, everything. And that book introduced me to the idea that I already had in my mind that came from the universe, but it confirmed it in a book. Says, we can live forever. This is ancient knowledge, secret knowledge of the Illuminati, man. We can live forever. All I needed to do was hear someone else say it. And it's like, oh, I already thought of that, man. But to hear someone else say it, it's like, yeah! Fuck yeah. So. Ah, Pee-wee. Give me a little pepper. Give me a little pepper. Let me put these books back, though. I'm feeling a little bit claustrophobic with all these books around me. I like it when things stay nice and neat, but I always go through periods where everything gets all messy. Because I need access to that account so I can organize my life, have time to kick back and organize, you know? All this freaking studying and struggling and trying to find how everything works and shit like that. God, I'll go good for a while, be nice and neat, and then all of a sudden I'll get on a tangent where I'm just like in deep, deep experimentation with life. And everything just goes to shit to the wayside, man. Then I gotta clean it all back up again. But then I learned from India that's the way they do it. They mix the Mount Everest water with polluted water it comes into together. And they all drink that polluted water. And they have the best immune systems on the earth. And they drink the water out of the bowls of the same animal. And they all shit and piss in it and everything. But the water automatically heals itself. And you learn all this when you see some India films, man. Yeah, so let me go get the brush. So, I got my fish tank heater in the tub right now, heating up the tub of water. It'll probably take all night to heat it up, so. So here we are, man. I smoked a couple cigarettes this winter. Probably about five, and I still got half of one. After experimenting with marijuana and finding out the benefits of it. Then I tried experimenting with some cigarettes, and I thought, oh shit, this cigarettes kind of give a nice relaxation too. But my dad said the secret to smoking cigarettes is you don't inhale all the way. Don't deep inhale, just lightly inhale. My dad's been smoking for years and years, and he goes and he gets checkups, and the doctor says, your lungs are fine. And my dad said that's because he only inhales very lightly. He doesn't deep inhale. He doesn't do it like this here. I gotta put my thoughts on it. All right, let's light. Damn. I gotta get this thing to light. Huh. I wonder if the arc went out on it. Looks like there's something stuck in it. Oh, there's some cotton shit stuck in it. Hold on. I had it in my pocket. I had me a little pocket of fur ball. You know the little fur balls you get in your pocket? It was stuck in the hole, man. It'll light now. The neighbor gave me this cigar. I went over and visited him because I knocked his power pole off. So I told him I want to repay him. But I had to hide. You know, I told him I had to go into hiding because bill collectors were after me. So I couldn't go over there and help him. And offer him and all that stuff. So I finally went over there. And when I did that, you know, that gave me all of a sudden the energy to, boom, break out. Because I was in prayer one day, and my prayer said, you need to go over there and make amends for tearing out his power line on his house. So I was cutting down a tree. I ripped his power line out of his house. And but I made it sound like that the winter storm did it. But that's because I didn't have no money. But he's an old man, so he understands these things. But so, and the whole family's over there, and you know, they visit and they take care of and all that, you know. And I told them, I says, yeah, I says, you know, and it was just a real light tree. It was just a real light tree limb, only like that thick, you know. But it was just enough, and he had an old, outdated weak power line on there, and the old house is old and it's kind of falling apart and stuff like that because he's old. He can't keep the house up, you know, junk in the yard and all that stuff like that. He can't really clean his yard up, stuff like that. So the wood rotted and it just, you know, the nails don't tie it anymore, and it's sitting on the house. So the wires going this way and it just pulled it right out. It's not like on my house. My power pole is up against the side of the house, boom, on the other side of the house, and then the wire's coming out, and it's all braced, because here's the house right here, and the pole's up there. But on his side of the house over here, his pole's on this side, so you can see how that works. It'll just rip right off, and it just ripped right off real easy. So he had to. He went up there and he put a chain on it and put it back in place, and everything worked fine until about 2 months later. Then it finally gave out. So when they came over to fix it, they told him it's an old, outdated thing. We have to put a whole brand new system in it, and it was $1,000. So when you're smoking cigarettes, if you breathe in real heavy like this, watch. That's what ruins your lungs. You just want to, like this, man. Just take a little puff. There's hardly any smoke at all, man. You know, My dad makes it real smoky. He French inhales. So he just, this is how you French inhale. You fill your mouth up with smoke and you just let it come up into your nose and you breathe real lightly through your nose like this. So that's how he does it. Doctor said, your lungs are good, man. That's what my dad told me. He says, you know, that's the secret of smoking. You don't breathe in heavily. And and I just naturally, you know, lately just do it that way. But if I have some marijuana, man, I take that stuff all the way in because I only have a little bit left. I only have a little bit. When I do have some, when I get some, I only have a little bit. And so I want to get the most out of it that I can, man. So I just, and I hold it in as long as I can, man, so I can get all the cannabis into my system as I can. I'll hold my breath until I can't hold it no more. I'll hold it for about, whatever, 30 seconds, a minute, and then finally let it out. So I get every ounce that's in the smoke into my system. That's how I stretch it out. Till they just made it legal here in Oregon, so we'll be able to grow our own and all that. And once I get my trust account, shit, I just go down to the store because I got shopping center right around the corner from you. I can just walk right down. It's only a block. They got a marijuana tobacco store all set up with vapor pipes and everything. They sell hookahs, the whole nine yards down there. All they're waiting for is it legalized, they'll be able to sell it. Once I get my trust check, I just go down if I really need some, just buy some, man. And so I'll be able to smoke it right on YouTube, man. No problem. And you will witness. I will do demonstrations how hyper I am naturally. And once I take some, you'll be like, whoa. Holy shit. Totally different dude, man. Just mellow, relaxed as can be, and clear thinking. Just total difference. You're gonna witness the difference right here on YouTube, what it's like. Yeah, it's gonna be awesome. So like I said, you know, I smoked about 5 cigarettes this year, so this is my 5th one. So, and it does make me a little relaxed. The tobacco does have a nice relaxing feeling, but if I just burn it up in my lungs and inhale it all real deep, then it's just painful. It's not a nice, relaxed feeling. It's kind of a discomfort. You know, that's because I'm sensitive. I'm very sensitive. You know, I allow myself to be very sensitive so I can realize the difference between just what I need and what gluttony is. Now, I have a hard time with food, though, because I like to devour food, man. But I'm working on it. I'm getting better at it. So. And once I get that trust account all set up, then I'll be able to eat all kinds of healthy food, man. A little meat here and there to tie me over so I can get myself off meat with protein substitutes and stuff like that, and all the technology that there is hiding, all the good stuff that there is. Thing about it, I smoke cigarettes so slow they go out easily. I gotta keep lighting them again. I have a pretty good check on cigarettes. I don't get addicted to them at all. So, but I am learning that they are a relaxant, man. They're a substitute for marijuana. And I can see how that works. So, get my arm muscle in there, man. Build my muscle back up. I dropped down to 125 pounds. That's what I was when I was 18 years old, man. From about high school, junior high and high school, I weighed the same. I was full grown. I quit growing in seventh grade. I was fully grown, 125 pounds, 5'7". Only thing that grew was my nose. It got a little longer, a little humpier. So I was on food bank food all summer, man. And food bank food is just enough to tie you over with supplements. But I stretched a whole food bank month of food bank for the whole month. And they have what's called get all you can get on Fridays over here in my town. So I'd go down there and I'd load up my bike trailer. Had me a little system where I could take my buckets inside, put them on a cart. I was the only one in there with two big giant buckets on a cart, pulling it with a handle, loading up the food for a month. All you can eat Fridays, man. I'd get comments that go in there and say, "Dan, you're smart. Dan, that's awesome. Man, look at that." Everybody was amazed, man. I hear stuff like, "Dang, you're a genius." I'd be like, thank you. But, I know I'm a genius. And, you know, it's not the IQ scores that tell me I'm a genius. It's just I know from learning, reading books, reading the Bible, studying religions, putting all the pieces of the puzzle together slowly but surely, that's what makes me a genius. Because now I see the full picture of how the world works. But now I got to put the final icing on the cake, and that's to become an international private banker. And it's coming. So, I just got to relax and wait for this, all the answers to come to me and read the signs of Mother Nature.